Alrighty, folks, give me a second. Actually, did I? Okay, I got my water. I'm good at that. I got that. Okay, we're good there. What do we do now? All I do know is that we're gone to, what, the third stream of the chaos that's going on? So we'll be starting that up. Keep that going. We're doing good.
I will admit.
I'm out of camera shot.
Also, I got a haircut. I got a haircut. It's nice. It's a very nice.
Very comfortable now. A lot easier to wash, too.
Very nice.
I see. Is that? There's that. Okay. Let's get this set up. Hopefully we don't die as much and we don't get elbowed. Because last stream was definitely interesting, to say the least. We did find out our dad escaped as well. So we're happy there. We're happy our father escaped. But we're at a summer camp that was once being used by the National Guard. And we don't know if they're still alive. So that's an interesting aspect. That's gonna be fun.
Not really, but can definitely lie about it.
Oh well. Next thing.
Yeah, that.
One thing I'm always curious about is how the fact that people didn't start like building their homes underground or anything like that. Oh wow, that's a lot more comfortable. That's a lot more comfortable. Having less hair to deal with, having it, than just having headphone hair kind of thing. Or headphone head. No head. Okay, press space. Good there. It looks like we got our little pruners right here. Let's see, what items do we have? Did we get a fork? I don't remember us getting a fork. The 3D model of these fuckers, that is cool looking. Continue.
We're at the campsite. We're at the campsite. Survive.
Day 119.
Thank God.
Let me just pause that for a second.
Go say hi to them. Say hi to them. Want to say hi to the folks? Okay, let's go say hi to them. Look at his pretty little face. What do you want to say to him? Here, what do you want to say to him? Here. Here. Come here. What do you want to say to him? What do you want to say to him? Here. You get that? Okay. Here. Okay, you're good.
Okay, there you go. There's our daily doggo report. And then there's Zeba right there. There's the good girl.
There's the baby girl right there. Oh, the pretty little babies. Just chilling in the bed.
You want me to move stuff around so you can lay down with her? Okay, folks, let's begin. I like this hairdo a lot better. The person who did my hair did a good job. Secret powers. Secret powers. Well, note to self, I guess that...
No!
Well then. Interesting. We almost had it. That was fun, to say the least. Seems to be we're safe. Seems to be we're in a safe spot. To be we are in a safe spot. It's an upside. Yeah, we already read that last time. This is the quietest I've seen someone climb a ladder.
Radio's working. Listen.
This is Task Force Empire to all available units. If you're receiving this message, convene at the harbor in Clinton. We're loading boats and we'll regroup in an island due east. The creatures cannot swim. I repeat, the creatures cannot swim. This is Task Force Empire to all available units. If you're receiving this message, convene at the harbor in Clinton.
Did you hear that? How long has it been since they recorded that? Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's our best bet. I'll pack. Meet me at the station.
I'm gonna bet you 10-1 odds that the mother-in-law is going to be at the station holding our dad at gunpoint. I'm gonna call it now. Just basing it off of my experience with playing video games like that. Like a Far Cry, for example, it's like, oh, you're supposed to go here and all that. Yeah. And then a few seconds later, your dad is killed off by a character that doesn't like you. I'm just basing it off of that information. Message. Oh, shit. It worked. Dad was right. The National Guard left for the town of Clinton to get on boats and sail for islands where the creatures can't reach them. But are we too late? Did they even make it? What's important is that we have a direction and even hope. Okay, back to Dad. I gotta admit, that's a nice ass drawing. to do that anyway. Just means that we're doing good so far. It's right there. I called it. I fucking called it. The bitch is back. I don't know why it
can't store more than one brick. What was that? Just had to be trigger happy, didn't they? Not now. You're so close. What has Laura done? Why did she do this? I can't. Had to be trigger happy, didn't she? He just had to be the little bitch that is. Get it that she might be our mother-in-law, but that is no excuse. There's no excuse to shoot someone and not be. I get it, she will be trying to prevent her, but the thing is, I don't see what the fucking problem is. She might be the child's grandmother and all that, but I do not have any remorse left for her. Eric, I spoke to you on the radio. This is my son, Joshua. Thank you. Thank you so much for taking us in. Like I said, I'm here to help. I'll go and hunt right now if you need me to, just so long as you keep Joshua safe. Can you do that? Can you keep him safe? You can? Can't you?
Well, god damn it. Again, he came in flying with that elbow. He came in flying with an elbow. But no, I was going to say, before we start this back up, still, there was no point in her shooting him, getting both herself and him killed. There was no fucking point. Come on. There, I know I'm freaking rambling on about it, but still. It's like, of all the things to do, shooting your gun isn't necessarily the safest thing to do in any situation, especially in this case. Whoops. There we go. He came in with that flying elbow. He'd be throwing elbows at everybody. But no, that's still bullshit.
I hope nothing but the worst. Exactly where I am.
Mate, you just stood there. What was I supposed to do? You just stood there.
He would freaking bust through it. I didn't realize I'd die so many times for one thing, and I'm still at the goddamn camp. God damn it.
No!
I'm surprised it doesn't go face first into ya. Give me a big old smooch. Give me a big old smooch, you big head. Been at this for
15 minutes. It's a little much, don't you think?
Thank you.
You gotta be fucking shitting me.
It was gonna wait till I got towards the end. It was gonna blue balls me. That's some bullshit.
Goddamn blue balls me. I can't believe it. Did I make it past? The mines. Survive? Are we gonna survive? Come on, tell me we survive on this. Thank you so much for taking it in me and my son. I am a nurse, and I am willing to repay you all for your kindness with any medical advice I can offer. However, I will not interact directly with anyone in severe pain. I cannot risk them screaming or lashing out. I cannot risk leaving Cameron without a mother. I hope you understand. Cat. Okay. Oh, now we're having our upset moment. We're doing good. If Laura tries to wake me up saying, like, hey, come on, we gotta get out of here, I'm gonna push her into that fucking waterfall and watch her go downstream.
I can't do this without you. I'm drowning. I don't know which way's up.
Damn, that's a... Honestly, I think the safest spot to stay would be, be staying as a waterfall or any water source, because it would cause you to be able to makes basically not much noise, but enough where it won't cause any harm. Oh, how did we get there? I can't believe this. Dad is dead. Did she kill him on purpose? Was it some kind of revenge? Was it an accident? Or for what? And for what? At least that creature got her. No, I don't mean that. I'm alone. I can't do this. Camp.
Nate, you just need some companionship. You're doing good. Though, I can't say much. Losing a family member, especially one as close as a father, or any family member for that matter, definitely would hit hard. So, I can't say much.
Just remember this, folks. If you feel like tearing up or anything like that, just go for it, okay? Whether it be privately or in someone's arms, just go for it. If you have someone there for you, go for them, okay? Just, if you need to let it out, just let it out. As she did here. I swear to God, if something starts running. This is cool. That is beautiful. That's a screensaver right there. That's a screensaver. Doing good so far. What's in here? I gotta admit, this is pretty spacey for a cavern. Thank you. sandbags. Carry sandbags and pour over noisy surfaces. This will let you walk on it with less noise. Goody. Good news. There's a couple of sandbags nearby. If we each take one, we can create a walking path without any risk of the creature hearing us. Okay. Go for a quick hit.
was a waste of time.
Okay. Okay, so which way do we go? Rock madness. I'm curious, how do I take my meds? I'm not actually asking on that aspect, because I already know how to take meds. Focus that, interact, crouch journal, call out, call items out. Okay.
He's the bird. He's the bird. It's...
Bird.
Okay, doing good.
Character name, Given, or Given, or player name, Gwen. Blood, or class, Blood Poet. Wait a minute. Oh shit, this is a D&D thing. this is D&D.
Playing D&D on the bus. Nice.
Derek, class Whisperer, Shadow Walker. Okay. Crossbow Rapier. Train ride one shot notes. Theophilus, Majestic Manor, party summoned by local wizard to assist with issue. Theophilus, the theoretical, powerful wizard. Is he actually there? Room for interpretation. The problem. Theo was having an issue with a lich. The lich is dead, but phylactery intact, if I pronounce that right. If for those who do D&D or anything like that, who know the word, please tell me. I'm concerned if I pronounce that wrong. Needs phylactery recovered intact before lich reconstitutes. Okay. The Lich was once a wizard himself. Family relation to Theo? Theo's secret. It must be phylactery. It is part of a wealthy collector's possessions transported by train. Theo, not sure which item is the phylactery. Theo loans one per PC player character. Stick of Sturdiness, Medallion of Manipulation, Rock of Resting. Gastenberg train station. Train to depart in 5 minutes. These motherfuckers were playing D&D on the train.
That's one way to do it. But I don't think that's able to be done.
Grungy Cats City Premiere, June 16th at 8 p.m. Venue, The Whale's Tomb. Tickets, $15 online and at the door. Two drinks minimum. Okay. Featuring songs, Flea Bomb, and What the Hack? Okay, I was gonna say, what the heck? Ethan, hey man, sorry to just leave you this in your guitar case, but I don't know how else to tell you without it turning into a screaming match. I'm done, dude. I'm leaving the band. I'm putting Grungy Cats behind me. I can't deal with all the drama anymore, and the pissing contests, and the stupid effing cat puns. For fuck's sake, so many cat puns.
I don't blame you. It can't get old. It's like dad jokes. But sometimes dad jokes can never get old.
I don't know about you, but they never get old for my case. They're always fun to listen to. Unless it's a really bad one, then that's a different conversation.
Cat's set list: To the Litter and Bottom of My Bowl, Chasing Tail, On the Rug, Flea Bomb, You Give Me Pause, Wake Up, What the Hack, Encore 1, Am I Your Scratching Post, Encore 2, It Was Always a Trap.
Thank you.
Doing good. Doing good. We're safe.
Hit the plane. Over there.
We're safe. We're in a good spot. Hopefully, at least. Okay, we'll recharge our battery, so we're good there. The question is, go. Still love the mechanics of the game. Supposed to go that way. How can it get worse? All this destruction, I'm afraid the natural... the natural guard, yes. They're all made of trees, they're Ents. They're goddamn Ents. But the National Guard didn't make it. What chance do I have if they couldn't make it? Martin, Dad, needs you. Agatha Grant, monologue. A lighthouse. No, not a lighthouse. A furnace. You are a goddamn furnace. At night, when you wrapped me in your arms, I felt the whole world melt away. Felt myself melt away. Nothing existed except for you. And to be honest, it felt good to just not exist for a while, a little while. But then, there were the times when I did want to exist, and still you burned. Still you engulfed everything around you. You weren't just at the center of it all, Allison. You were it all. I loved you for it. I hated you for it. I worshipped you. I feared you. I didn't exist before you and never existed with you. You were my everything. And now, there's no fire, no light, and I am cold. But I am here. I exist. God forgive me. But I really don't know how I feel about that. Handwritten notes on the bottom of the page. Objective, to ask for forgiveness, to keep from drowning. Substitutions, Jack equals love for Allison. Mom equals Allison's narcissism. Interesting. Moment before, circled the block outside the funeral home for an hour before finally coming inside. It'd be like that sometimes. Did a really good job doing this. Well, I'm dead. Well, I hope the baby's okay. Grungy Cat demo tape. Nice. City trip restaurants checklist. They have this thing called pepperoni pizza that has a layer of pepperoni, a layer of cheese, another layer of pepperoni. Genius. Sushi 45 East, check. Between the two of us, eating here will probably cost me a whole paycheck, but you only live once. Am I right? Giuseppe's Ristorante. Check. Garlic cheese rolls. Robert's Steakhouse. Next time. Even if we don't eat here, we should at least check out the steaks dry aging in their window. Grand Hall Oyster Bar. Check. Okay. This is much more for me than you. But hey, you love me, right? Who's this? Damn, I need a checklist like that. Viv, be careful. I mean, extra careful. Something weird just happened with one of the creatures. I think it was trying to listen for me, but not like usual. It's like the creature was scanning for me. I could be wrong, but I think just being quiet won't be enough when they're like that. Let's pray I'm wrong. I haven't had a problem yet. So we're doing good. Printed on the outside of the card. Get well soon. Handwritten inside of the card. Abby, part of me feels foolish writing you this card, not knowing if you'll ever read it, but the other part of me needs to believe, no, does believe that you will wake, and I want it to be the first thing you see. I'll be back as soon as I can. Your sister, Madison.
Oh, how sweet. Too bad she's probably dead.
The blood streaks don't help the situation.
go. I did it!
Day one.
No, I can't go any faster.
What are those things?
The hospital must be a madhouse. It is Ken.
He hasn't called back. We'll be there soon.
I should have gone with him.
They're gaining on us! What do we do?
The only thing we can. Alex here.
Don't give her a gun!
You can't shoot!
Laura's right. I don't know how to shoot.
Simple. Right. Point, shoot, and reload. Like this.
Out of the way!
They're coming!
Get the fuck off us, bitch. Come at me. Wait, you can't kill the creatures, but you can shoot their claws to make them fall. Gotcha. Okay, come on, where are you coming from?
On the left.
How about a nail job, bitch? Come at me. Horspital. There we go. Where you coming from, bitch? Come on, bro. Have another nail job. Get off of our ship.
Alex?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Fucking fight me, bitch.
Nice, Alex. Nice.
Bro's like, hey, you're closer. Okay, good.
The hospital.
God, it's such a shh.
Look out, look out!
Jesus!
What happened? Alex? What?
Dad? Shit!
Just breathe.
Yeah, come on.
You got this.
I told you not to give her a gun.
Man, shut your ass up, Laura. Just pay attention to the road. Goddamn.
Right to your right!
How about another nail job, bitch? Okay, come on. Let's go. Come on, let's go.
Look right!
How about another nail? Okay. God damn it, how many times do I have to tell you? You don't need a manicure, honey, you need nail. You need nail to make yourself look pretty. Shut your ass up.
Alex, look up!
I said no, Becky. Go away. And here we go, crash. Hey, I gotta admit, we stood our ground. Somehow we're Spider-Man.
And that's where the bitchiness started. Sorry, I constipated. Ouch. I was able to get the lights working again, but I'll be honest, I don't know how long they'll keep they're going to last since we can't actually swap out the wiring. Keep a couple of flares on you in case things go dark again. You run out of flares, grab the dynamo flashlight, but let's only use that in emergencies. Dev. Okay. Must have blacked out. That day, the day everything began, was it my fault? Would we have lost Robert anyway? For months, I've tried telling myself it was inevitable, but still, the guilt never fades. I can't turn back time. I can't change what happened. I can't even look ahead. It's too damn dark. One thing, okay. I'm gonna call it there for today. I do have to say, I don't think it was completely her fault because her son started groaning. So if anything, it's the son's fault, okay? The son's fault that he's dead, okay? We didn't do anything, okay? Because technically, the monster only came back after the son was making noise. Besides that, all we did was pull the trigger. Then after that, the father tried to pull the trigger as well, but didn't do it in time. So he got napped, and personally, I find it kind of insulting. But the thing is, she has a huge grudge and blaming us because we're the only person that's alive. We're the person that's alive because of it. That comes with the thing, like, the, you know how, like, people get angry with other people for, like, the people that were saved compared to the people who sacrificed themselves? Like, anything like that. Most of the time people get angry with the saved because the ones who get sacrificed to save another life are the family members who get upset with the saved. If that makes any sense, if you guys understand my drift. Look at her. Look at her. She just chilling right there. Look at the pretty babies. But no, I'm going to call it there for tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know not many people joined to watch or anything like that, or people went to interact and all that stuff, but I do have to say, I'm getting tired. But thank you guys so much for watching, and without further ado, have a good morning, good evening, good afternoon. I will see you guys in the next one. I hope to see you guys on Friday. See you guys then.